So upper on the chow time.
In a second, I'm about to tell you about Rikers Island, house gang, the food, and why it don't matter who they put as house gang to serve the food, it's always gonna be a problem. Let's go. This is on the lockout. So now, Rikers Island, the food, for those of you that been there, and if you haven't been there, good for you. Don't ever go there. Worst place on earth. So now, it's always going to be a problem because there's a Muslim dude to serve the halal food, right? There's supposed to be a regular dude to serve the regular food, right? And then there's a dude, if I'm not mistaken, to serve the culture meals, the diet trays, whatever, right? For what I remember, it was always three dudes. I never, and I think one like a spare tire, like an extra, you know what I'm saying? In case one of these ain't there, womp, you take over, bro, right? So I always said I'm never gonna be house gang, man. With this whole serving of the food thing, a lot of people say, or some people say, that's not house gang, the dudes that serve the food. That's pantry. I don't know what you want to call that. A pantry, to me, could be the dudes just to go get the pantry, and the food service would be called food service. If you want to break it all down to its original terminology, I guess, right? But the bottom line is that don't matter what it is, pantry, house gang, or if you just want to call house gang the dudes that clean up, or whatever, right? Which is like the porter upstate. You know, it's different names that people want to call it. It doesn't matter to me. To be real, the name doesn't matter. I looked at all of them, like house gang on the island, the porter up top, and in the back of my head, I looked at them like the dudes that work for Popo, the dudes that are always talking to the police, to the COs. Facts. Maybe not all, because you got some dudes that still did their job but wasn't all like smoochy smooch with the COs. So we don't want nobody getting crazy and offended, but I wasn't. But listen, the majority was, don't let nobody fool you. They was there. All over this, you heard facts.
He ain't even lying. Yeah,
so some may not be that way, but a lot was. Number one, I was already in a gang, so you don't want to be rolling with two gangs. But to make a long story longer, right? People try to put a Latino gang member, whatever gang's in the house, because gangs will always exist in the prison system on Rikers Island and everywhere. It's just facts.
Word. Right? They multiply.
Five of them leave,
like
10
bucks.
More come in. You're like, damn, right? So in those times when I was there, it was try to put a Latin King dude, a blood dude, and a Muslim dude is usually the people that they want there because these are the people in the house, right? So of course, the other gang or whoever sees that the Spanish dude is like hitting one of his people off more.
Jealous.
Or, you know, so they got their own internal beefs going on. And then you got the people that's looking from the outside in. And here you go. Even if it's not gang members that are running house gang, the gang members still control like house gang on the low, because it's like, bro, if I don't get extra, I'm gonna break you up. And it's like that in a lot of places, and in some it may not be. Certain houses is all good, right? But for the most part, there's always a problem with house gang, because looking from the outside in, right, you're looking at him like, bro, he just took a loaf of bread to his locker.
Greedy.
Yo, he just took 10 milks. Yo, he's giving people a little bit of jelly. And that people on the outside always feel like there's more. Like, why we can't get more? Why can't get extra?
Because you
soft. You know what I'm saying? Everybody always wants extra. So, as you on that line and they say regular, you know, and everybody run with your green cup, boom, right? Or some, you know, you play the back of the line like you ain't really sweating, but your ribs is clapping. So, as you on that line, it's always this sound that I remember, right? It's like a bing, pop, boom, 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 yo, boom, 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 yo, boom, yo, why you wailing? Boom, 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 yo, break it up, break it up, boom, 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 boom. It's on, bro, huh? Right? It's like a sound. I don't know if you know that popping off sound, like, yo, it popped, song, right? And then you see the dudes that are making believe like they was doing something, like they sleeping, like, yo, you sleep through the whole thing, bro.
Nah, he's like, you just know, a so bitch, B.
That sound is always going to exist because when people get there and they don't know the rules and regulations, or when it seems like somebody else is taking advantage or they eating more than the next people, people have a problem with it. But as I got older, I started seeing like, damn, bro, like they serving the food. Like they should get a little bit extra. Like they doing all that. Some people feel like they got paid for that. Some people feel like if there's not extras for everybody, then just don't take extras. But leave in the comment section if you ever been there, if you think it's always going to be a problem, if you agree with me. Don't matter why, I never seen a smooth running house gang. And this is something else that happens with house gang. Right?
Bro, house gang and cleans. When they say food.
So-and-so, let's say Edward Martinez. The dude be like, yeah, what's up? Pack it up. Tyrone Johnson. Yeah, what's up? Pack it up. And they house gang? Dumb dudes go, wow. Like, yo, I'ma get packed up. I'm house gang. You shook? Because they've been there like 18 months. They comfortable. And now they like, yo, where I'm going? To the Beacon. And he's like, man, it's popping over there, right? So very few house gang dudes just pack their stuff up and go with no problem. Most of them, the CO starts calling if he's like a good worker, right? They start calling the control room like, yo, you can't pack this dude up. He's like my house gang, you know? And they try to leave it alone for the most part, but sometimes it's up, pa. It's time to go, you heard? You got to go. There's nothing we can do about it. It's a wrap, right? And then comes the problem for who's going to take that spot. Who's going to be the next regular server to serve for his people? And who's going to be the next black brother to serve for his people? And it's a sad situation, right, when you really think about it. But you know, in a different aspect, I kind of sort of understand it because some people feel comfortable when it's their own people serving them the food. I don't know. A lot of people, like if you Allah and you Muslim, they'll be like, I don't want a regular dude serving my food because he touched pork and all that. He eat pork, it's reeking out of him, you heard? He's a Goya dude, you heard? Like, so I don't know, but leave in the comments how you felt about house gang. Have you ever encountered any problems with any house gangs? How was your experience with the house gang at Rikers Island? Because the house gang be getting some lumps, bro. Like, that's one thing. If you ever go to Rikers, bro, and you trying to work, like, I'm not trying to sound like whatever, but when I was there, we couldn't work because we was SRG, security risk gang members. Thanks God by the Almighty Father, right? Today, we don't do the gang thing, right? We YouTubers.
This nigga so, more full of shit.
So, I gotta laugh when people say that. The dude is a YouTuber. All right, cool. But anyway, yeah. So leave how you feel about the situation. How was it when you seen house gang? Have you ever had any fights with house gang?
My G, you know,
I understand it a little more now than I'm older, but when I was there, there was a lot of problems with house gang. I pounded some house gangs out. You know, I got tight. One time, I said the story before, it wasn't even because of me. It was that a dude gave one of my peoples like a broken up chicken. Meanwhile, he just changed it for the other dude. But passed it to my broski, and I'm like, the bro looked at me and I'm like, yo, what up? You can't change that. Boom, hit him with the tray. It got lit. All crazy. I was, as a matter of fact, I was on the boat. Facts. I don't know. They used to call it like MTF3 back then. I don't know. If you remember what they used to call that boat, holla. I think it was called that. That's shit. When I was with King Korea and all that. The dude that gave me my name, Warpath, in the super early 90s. In fact, it was like a 92, 93. It was a super early 90s. I know that. But anyway, with that being said, man, house gang, the food at Rikers Island, that's always a problem. You know, house gang, this is not a secret. You know, it's something that you could probably Google doing all this stuff. You could probably Google it. You know, they're the ones that get to make like extra little moves. You understand what I'm saying? Like if you need a little finger, you know what I'm saying, which is the tobacco, they, you know, they can mingle and they get out more than anybody, because when the food comes, that's when it's time, boom. But nowadays, most COs and all that, they up on all that, you know, because the CO himself was making moves at that time, you heard? Facts. So, you know, a lot of things are probably getting a little stricter, but there's still a lot of things going on. Like, that's never going to change. The way Rikers Island is, you know, and the hopes of changing the system and the ways already embedded in the people that are there and the people that keep coming through again because it's a revolving door. We all know that. So that's never going to change, because the only thing that's changing is location. So they say, like, it's haunted with drama, with beef. Like, the, you know what I'm saying? Like, the name of it gives it, like, a thing where people feel they got to go in there and be tough. These things are just natural things that happen with human beings. Like, yo, the food. Like, dudes is hungry. Like, the animal instincts come in. Like, you better give me more, you know? But there was times in places where I was at with house gang, right? Like, we always ate, you know what I'm saying? But this is a fact thing, that when they gave certain foods, you couldn't get up for breakfast to eat. And I'm pretty sure right now, it's still like that in a lot of houses. That's a fact. Because the dude who's running the house, if they gave Frosties, he would keep all the Frosties. So do not wake up for breakfast. Like, people already knew. Like, in the morning, a lot of cuttings and fights happen over that food. But it's not necessarily the food, because we all know that it's nasty unless it's like Frosties. And I was told they stopped even giving them like that. I'm not sure, because I haven't been there like in, you know, in the last 30 days. So my thing is, the food has always been like that, where somebody is hogging something, right? But it's not so much the food, because it's nasty. It's the act. You know, that another dude that sometimes don't even eat mess or food will be watching, and he feels he's about it and he's tired of it. You know what I'm saying? And he feels that either the Hispanics are abusing too much, the Blacks are abusing too much, or the Muslim brothers are abusing too much. Either way, right? But in the process, the person who's serving, they don't feel none of this. They're not feeling none of this. They feeling as if they're entitled to it because they're serving the food, like they're working, right? So leave in the comments if you feel that they should get all the extras. But there was some house gang, I ain't gonna lie, that do spread the love. And most of the time when I was in a spot, I would get like a lot of bread, like a loaf of bread or half, and I would split it with people because it wasn't my thing. That bread is solid, but there was times that they'll get a little extra bread that was a little soft. And, you know, we heat it up. You know, we try to make moves and make it soft, as hard as that is to do in the Rikers. But I used to always get extra bread for the nighttime. Whoever had, you know, something to put on it, pom pom, or we had peanut butter. However it went down, whatever you was putting on it, cheese, bologna, whatever you like. You know what I'm saying? But I would get extra bread for what I recall, right? And, you know, like bananas, stuff like that. Like things that are not... they even taste different at Rikers, but it was better than anything else. But yeah, house gang, I feel that they always, no matter what happens, are gonna be getting like pounded on. It's just point blank. Like, I don't see it no other way. And every time I was there, something happened with house gang. Always. You see, like, even when there's a search, house gang comes out to do the sweep up. You know what I'm saying? You got some house gang dudes that do be like, yo, get that for me, whatever, you know, and grab something real quick and be like, I don't see it in here. Like, you know, you got some dudes like that. What? Munson better be there, boy. I'm pounding you out when I come out. So a lot of things happen with house gang. And as I'm thinking about it over here, it's like, yo, wow. I seen house gang dudes really, really get it, bro. Like cut, stabbed up, you know, like jumped where the whole house just washed them up. Like, brrr, like it's over for you. You out of here. You know, it's just crazy. Like, it's not worth it to me. Like, what they giving house gang, like, it was like $8 or something like that. Like, I don't even know their pay. You know what I mean? But whatever it is, bro, I'm pretty sure it's definitely not worth that ass whipping from a bunch of dudes that is hungry. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I just wanted to let people know that because a few times people ask me, was I ever house gang? Like, nah, I was never house gang. But one thing is for sure and two things is for certain that when you in a house and you feeling like you the man or something, right? Or people know like you may be somebody in the house, you're going to get your little extras because I always got extras, right? But people were tight around me and I could tell, you know what I'm saying? And you feel the tension, you know what I'm saying? And sometimes there's nothing you could do, bro. Like, bro, they gave beef patties and there's only 4 extra beef patties. You were supposed to split it amongst everybody. You feel me? So there was times that I already had, even in places, I would hit house gang off. I would hit the dudes from the kitchen. What they call that? KK? I don't know. I forgot. But yeah, then they call it KK. From the kitchen, yeah. So leave in the comments what they call that again, bro, when you work in the kitchen. I think I'm right, but I could be wrong, right? I don't know. I'm not always right. So, because my brain shot. But anyway, I used to get, like, different stuff from people. There was a time that me and there was this dude named Kojak from the Bronx, right? That he talks like, oh, yeah, papa. Yo, what's up? Yo, my G, yo. Yo, what up? He's a big, the tall Kojak. Not Kojak, the black brother that he looks Hispanic. I know him. Not Kojak, the blood dude. This Kojak, I don't even know if he was a Latin King or what he was, but he was around me all the time, right? And he was cool. If I'm not mistaken, he was from 183rd, that Kojak. But he talked like, yo, nene, what up? But he got it in. You know what I'm saying? He did his thing, whatever he did, that's his business. But he walked around with his chain on and all that. You know, he wasn't no slouch. If you know who I'm talking about, leave it in the comments. Hopefully he's still alive, right? And if you see this, holler at me, bye-bye. So anyway, Kojak was one that always came through like with lasagna, facts. I ain't even gonna lie to you. I ain't even gonna hold you, bro. A whole, the pans with chicken, like fried chicken, cheese, like melted, yo, some crazy stuff. Lasagna, like, cause we was paying, you know, we was getting to the bag at that time, right? This was a long time ago. I don't want this, the feds to casting over me, you know? And because we saying a story now, we get locked up for something that we did on Rikers in the past. That's so crazy. So anyway, Kojak used to send to get the trays, right? Because I didn't have to put up no bread. Like if Kojak is getting it, you know what I'm saying? I was his man's, you know what I'm saying? So we tell him, we used to get all the extra food, but you could tell like the hate from other inmates. Like, yo, bro, you need to get your hustle on. Like Rikers Island is like about survival. It's not even like about, it's about survival, right? And if you one of those dudes that's just gonna lay back or be in your cell 24/7, you know, some people do it because they want to have an easy bid. The majority do it because not that they don't want to get in. Some of them don't want to get in trouble, right? But you don't have to do nothing to get in trouble. Sometimes it comes right to you. But some dudes just play their cell all day. And me, my belief, 90% of the time when a dude just stay in a cell all day, he's shook. You know what I'm saying? And people sense that, like that you shook. And then not at all, not all. So don't take it offensively if you played your bunk like a chump, right? It's not me throwing at you. Some people are really stressed out. Some people, the looking at the environment and the pettiness, like, kills them and depresses them, and they don't want no part of it, you know? But And sometimes some dudes that play their cell a lot, you could get it confused. He could be one of the most dangerous dudes in the world. Like, he could be in there thinking so bad about how he wants to change things in the house that one day he just comes out like, "Wah! Yo, what's up?" And you like, holy snap. Like, those things happen. You know what I'm saying? You like, oh, boom, boom, what's popping? You feel me? You know, the element of surprise is a moon. Okay, you heard? Facts. So, house gang, Rikers Island, leave in the comments if you ever been house gang, if you ever got your lumps for being on house gang, and have you ever seen any house gang things pop off because the fights over house gang happen on the regular. Facts. You already know. This is the part where I tell you, if you ever thought about making content like this or any content, right? Let me say just any content, because not everybody needs to be doing content like this, right? Because people start super lying and telling like extra stories, right? But I'm not the catching police. But please, bro, do not lie to the people. It's like super noticeable. Like, one thing that I try not to do is when somebody leaves in the comments, like, yo, talk about this gang. Yo, how was it with the, let's say, hypothetically speaking, with the, let's say, Savage Skulls at Rikers when you was there. Like, they wasn't there when I was there. But somebody else would just make it, when I was there with the Savage Skulls, I seen one Savage Skull dude, bro. He was a killer, you know, and just start making shit up, bro. Like, it's crazy, but you already know. Too much conversation leads to unnecessary information. If you ever thought about making content, just do it. These platforms are made for everybody. But you know what you gotta do? You gotta do something, find a niche, something that you like to do, something that makes you happy. You don't gotta do what everybody else is doing. Therefore, whatever you do that's different is gonna stand out and it's gonna take off. Facts. When you're doing a little bit of all the same, it's like, oh, I saw this already. Facts. You already know what this is on the lockout.